Last period we have seen preparation of missionary account and a depreciation account under written down value method. So we completed two main methods of calculating depreciation: fixed installment method and written down value method. Okay, so today I'm going to start difference between fixed installment method and written down value method. So already you know difference between fixed installment method and written down value method. Then we will start second provision for depreciation. So extra two questions there that we will do. So first, difference between fixed installment method and written down value method. Fixed installment method, amount of depreciation is same every year. Year after year, every time, the amount of depreciation is same. Written down value method, it is not same. Goes on reducing year after year. Is it correct? So it reduce year after year. Next, second one, depreciation is computed, calculated on the original cost of the asset. It is calculated on the original cost of the asset because we are calculating depreciation on the basis of original cost, not on the basis of the balance BD, not on the basis of the current value, on the basis of original cost. Here, it is calculated on the written down value of the asset. Written down value means asset minus depreciation, balance BD. That only balance BD. So on that basis only, we are calculating depreciation. Next, third point, the value of the asset is reduced to zero or a residual value at the end of its working life. So if you are calculating depreciation according to fixed installment method, at the end of its working life, the value will be zero. Otherwise, scrap value we will get. If you are following fixed installment method. But if you are following, suppose 10,000, 1 lakh, 10% is depreciation. So 10,000. So lifetime is 10 year. So after 10 year, the value of asset will be zero. Okay, that is according to fixed installment method. But if you are calculating a depreciation according to written down value method, the value of asset will not become zero after its effective working life. After the lifetime also, if you are following, first 1 lakh, first year 10,000, next year 9,000 depreciation. So it will not become zero after the lifetime. Next, total charge for depreciation and repairs relating to an asset to profit and loss account will be lesser in the initial years and more in later years. What it meaning? It will be lesser in the initial years and more in the later years. Because if you are following fixed installment method, first year we know that asset will be 1 lakh. So that depreciation is 10,000. Okay, no problem. Second year, the value of asset will be how much? 90,000 only. But we are charging depreciation 10,000. Okay, so next year, 81,000 value. But we are charging depreciation 10,000. So the amount of depreciation will be lesser. If you are considering the asset value, if you are calculating depreciation under fixed installment method means will be lesser in the initial years and more in later years. But under a written down value method, almost equal throughout the title of the assets. Throughout the lifetime, the value will be equal. Means on the basis of the asset only, we are calculating depreciation. Okay, but here, under fixed installment method, we are not considering the written down value, value of current value. Only we are considering original cost. So first year it will be less, then it will be, the value of depreciation will be more in the later years. Next, this method is adopted for assets of lesser value. Assets have a lesser value in this method only, which is suitable fixed installment. But written down value method is suitable for assets having longer life. Assets have more life. In that case, which method is suitable? Written down value method. Machinery, building, land, plant. Okay. So in this case. So next, last point, that is specifies, it is not recognized by the income tax law. According to income tax law, we can't follow which one, fixed installment method, but written down value method, it is recognized by the income tax law. We are got recognition from income tax law, so we have to follow which one, written down value method. That is the difference between fixed installment method and written down value method. So written down value method is best one, because here we are calculating depreciation according to which one, current value. So you look at it, insurance, bike insurance, motor vehicle insurance, car insurance, how they are calculating insurance on the base of the current value. First year it will be 10 lakh, next year they will calculate on the base of 9 lakh. Okay, so written down value method is recognized by the income tax law. So these are the difference between amount of depreciation is same, here it is not same. Depreciation is calculated on the base of original cost, here it is calculated on the base of written down value. Here the value of asset is reduced to zero after the end of its working life. Here the value of asset will not be become zero. Then the amount of depreciation will be lesser in the initial years and more in the later years. Here all the value of depreciation will almost equal throughout the title of the asset. Next, this method is adopted for assets of lower value. This method is suitable for assets having longer life. Next, it is not recognized by the income tax law, fixed installment method. Then it is recognized by the income tax law. Okay, so these are the difference between fixed installment method and the written down value method. Next, last point related to depreciation. Then one more theory is there, reserve and provision. That is theory only. Next one, methods of recording depreciation. Methods of recording depreciation. There are two methods of recording depreciation. First one, depreciation is directly charged to asset account. Depreciation is directly charged to asset account. And the second one, depreciation annually provided and accumulated in a separate account. In a separate account. Means provision for depreciation account method. Means first method already we did. So again, no need to do. Depreciation is directly charged to asset account. Means if there is any depreciation related to assets, that we will credit to asset account. So entry, you know, depreciation on asset. What is entry? Depreciation on depreciation account to machinery, depreciation account to furniture. That is first method. So no need to explain again. So there are two methods, fixed installment and written down value method. Already we did. Okay, if it is a depreciation is there, depreciation account to machinery, depreciation account to furniture. That is first method, already we did. So now we need to do that one. So second one, depreciation accumulated in a separate account. Depreciation accumulated in a separate account. Here what we are doing, we are accumulating depreciation. So in this case, if any depreciation on asset is there, entry will be not depreciation accounted to asset. That is first method, depreciation accounted to asset, depreciation accounted to machinery, that we are writing in the first method. Here if any depreciation is there, here we are accumulating, so entry will be depreciation accounted to provision for depreciation or accumulated depreciation. Depreciation account to provision for depreciation. Clear? But first method, what is entry if depreciation is charging? Depreciation account to asset account. Here, instead of crediting asset, we are crediting what? Accumulated depreciation or provision for depreciation. Provision for depreciation. So when only we will credit to which one, asset account? At the time of sale. So at the time of sale, at the time of a sale of the asset. So what we accumulated means every year we will accumulate. Suppose we purchased one asset of rupees 1 lakh. Okay, so 10% is depreciation. 10% is depreciation. So what we'll do? So after 3 years, we will sell this asset for rupees 60,000. Suppose, okay. After 3 years, opening date only. After three years, we are selling this asset. So what is entry? So depreciation account to provision for depreciation 10,000. So 3 years this entry, depreciation account to provision for depreciation 10,000. Next year 10,000. Then at the time of sale, entry will be that we have to charge to asset. So that time only we will transfer to asset account. Entry will be provision for depreciation account asset. How much amount? The total accumulated, the accumulated one. Okay, daily every year what is entry? Depreciation account to accumulated provision for depreciation 10,000 until the sale of the asset. At the time of sale, that time only we will transfer that accumulated depreciation to asset account. So entry will be accumulated provision provision for depreciation account to asset. Provision for depreciation account to asset. Okay. Here means you look at that, what this method is more useful in that it gives the original cost of the asset year after year and depreciation accumulated till date. Here we are showing. So in the first method, if you are following, every year asset value will be, it will change. Here means it will not change. We will give the original cost every year. When only it will change? At the time of sale. At the time of the sale only, the original cost will change. Otherwise, same amount. So if you are doing, if you do the two problem, then you will understand. Within one problem, you will understand. Remaining sale. So what is the first entry? Same asset account to cash, no problem. Depreciation is there. What is entry? Depreciation account to provision for depreciation. Depreciation account to provision for depreciation. When only that accumulated depreciation will transfer to asset? At the time of sale, retirement, at the time of sale of asset, entry will be provision for depreciation account to asset. Then normally sale, what is entry? Bank account to asset. Then we will find the profit or loss, balance BD minus accumulated depreciation, that and sale value will compare. Same like other type. Only one thing you have to remember, at the time of sale only we will credit to asset account, that accumulated one, total one. So at the time of, after the end of 4 year only means we will write 40,000. Every year we will write 10,000 depreciation account to provision for depreciation. At the time of sale, accumulated provision for depreciation account to asset, that cumulated one. So if it is 3.5 year means 35,000. Okay. So this is depreciation accumulated in a separate account. Here means we are opening provision for depreciation account. Okay, so we will show original cost every year. At the time of sale only, we will show the depreciation. Okay, so we will start the problem. In this, we have to prepare asset account and provision for depreciation account. Okay, provision for depreciation, you look at what is entry. Depreciation account to provision for depreciation. Then next this entry will come, provision for depreciation to asset, when at the time of sale. Okay, normally first method, what is entry? Depreciation account to machinery. Here note that depreciation account to provision for depreciation, at the time of sale provision for depreciation account to asset. We are cumulating means what? We are keeping reserve. Then at the time of sale, that it will transfer to asset account. Okay, so we'll start. Look the problem. X Limited purchased on 1st April 2000 when provision for depreciation account is maintained. That costly first one. First one is fixed installment method. Second one, written down value method. X Limited purchased on 1st April 2012 a second hand plant for rupees 4 lakh and immediately spent 80,000 for its overhauling and 20,000 for its installation. So up to installation, whatever the expense are included, that is included in the aspect, respective asset account. On 1st October 2015, the plant became obsolete and sold for rupees 2 lakh. Depreciation is provided at 10% per annum on the original cost method. Accounts are closed every year on 31st March. Show the necessary ledger account assuming that provision for depreciation account is maintained. It's second method. So we will do easy only. Easy method. First machinery account. Okay. 1st April 2012. Machinery account. So two account you have to prepare. Machinery account and provision for depreciation. This is, if you have any doubt, you can ask. First, same like asset purchased, no change. April, we purchased 1st April 2012 to cash. Five lakh. How? 4 lakh. Four lakh plus 80,000 plus 20,000. So 5 lakh. Now no other purchase. Now 15 only we are selling. So closing date 31st March 2013. Thing is that here, what is the entry for depreciation, Karthik? Depreciation entry, depreciation charged under provision for depreciation account method.
Depreciation account at 2.
Yes. 2? Machinery or provision for depreciation?
Provision for depreciation.
Yes. Depreciation account at 2, provision for depreciation. So, no asset. So, we will write by balance sheet 5 lakh first year, because no depreciation.
Depreciation. Sir,
tell.
Which is the question?
When provision for depreciation account is maintained?
Which? 1 minute.
Okay. So 5 lakh, 5 lakh. Now, because this method is useful, that point you have to remember. For showing the original cost year after year. Next year, 1st April 2013 to balance BD, 5 lakh. Means at the time of sale only, the amount of depreciation will change. Otherwise, so when only we are selling 1st October 2015. So 31st March 2014, same, no change by balance CD, 5 lakh. Next, 1st April 2014 to balance BD. Here also we are not selling. 1st October 2015 only. Next year only we are selling. 5 lakh. So 31st March 2015 by balance CD. 5 lakh. Clear? It shows the original assets. When only it will change at the time of sale, because here depreciation entry is depreciation account to provision for depreciation. When only it will transfer to asset at the time of sale. At the time of sale, what is entry? Provision for depreciation account to provision for depreciation account to asset. Sharat, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. So next, last year. First April 2015 to balance BD. To balance BD, 5 lakh. 5 lakh, save. Now, this year, 1st October 2015, we sold. So I said, at the time of sale, what is entry, if any depreciation is there, Aditya?
Depreciation account that are to provision for depreciation account.
No, that is normal. At the time of sale, accumulate provision for depreciation account to asset. Okay, provision for depreciation account to asset. So, 1st October 2015 by provision for by provision for depreciation account, by provision for depreciation account. So we'll write the amount. So we sold by bank. So we know it is given, we sold for rupees 2 lakh. We sold for rupees 2 lakh. Now, so we can write one working note, because here we have to calculate depreciation. So first you have to look when we sold. So accumulated depreciation, this one, for calculating provision for depreciation, you have to write one note. So you look at that first year, second year, 3 year full we used that machinery. First year full, second year full, third year full. Then fourth year, 1st April to 110, 6 month we used. Clear? This machinery, 1 year, this year full we used. Second year full we used. Third year full we used. Fourth year, half only we used. Clear? So first year, it is a fixed installment method. So we know that 5 lakh is the 5 lakh. 5 lakh is the original cost, depreciation 10%. So first year depreciation 50,000. Second year depreciation 50,000. Third year depreciation 50,000. Fourth year, bracket half only 6 month only we used. So 6 month, 25,000. So 1,75,000. that only accumulated depreciation, provision for depreciation. Clear? So provision for depreciation, so we can't write 50,000 here means at the time of sale accumulated one till now, how much depreciation? First year full we used 50,000, second year full we used 50,000. But if it is a returned out value method, so you have to look 5 lakh minus 50,000, then 4 lakh 50,000, 10% like that you have to calculate. Here means fixed installment method, it is easy. So directly 50 50 50, then last year 25, so 1 lakh 75,000 over. Now we will calculate profit or loss. So we know that credit side only balance figure we can write, otherwise 5 lakh is the amount, that depreciation 1 lakh 75,000 depreciation, so 3 lakh 25,000 is the current value, sold for rupees 2 lakh, sold for rupees 2 lakh. So loss only, so by profit and loss 1 lakh 25,000. Okay, over. Asset account is over. Okay, at the time of sale we will open provision for depreciation. So how to write the amount? So first year, so first you have to look how many year we used that machinery, so 3.5. So first year full 50,000, second year 50,000, third year 50,000, fourth year 25,000. Now provision for depreciation, provision for depreciation. So here we know that charging depreciation, what is entry? End only we are charging depreciation normally. So every closing date you have to 31st March 2013, 31st March 2014, 31st March 2015. So at the time of sale only provision for depreciation account to asset, otherwise depreciation account to provision for depreciation. Now we are preparing ledger for provision for depreciation. So that you have to remember, two entry will be there, depreciation account to provision for depreciation, then at the time of sale provision for depreciation account to asset.